been on my own for long enough. Maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe.
Song game number four, you guys. Song game number four. I need the name of the song, and I need the artist. You're going to email it to me, okay? So we'll let this play. Okay, guys, that's song game number four. If you're playing along, I need the name of the artist and the name of the song, and you're going to email it to me, Hogan PS. First one that comes in, obviously you're in the running. Put your name in for some pizza or Chick-fil-A or Panera or whatever gives us food. All right. Moving into 1.6, this is going to be a really good unit for us, possibly looking for an IA topic, and this is going to be called growth and evolution. So as we started out, we were building this house, building this business out, and one of the main things that they need to do is we need to grow. So why would we need to grow? It would be the next thing. Like, I'm pretty content, you know, I have one little store making what I need to make, and everything's good. The reason that you want to continue to grow, okay, is to operate on what we call economies of scale. So economies of scale, okay, is, I'm just going to put it, is lowest average cost, lowest average cost. So with this, we want to try and grow to operate on economies of scale to reach a point where we have the lowest average costs for making our goods or providing our services. And the reason that you want to do this, number one, you want to stay competitive. Okay, if you can operate on economies of scale as compared to your competitors, you're going to be able to offer lower prices in the market because your costs are low, therefore passing that savings on in price to, okay, your consumers or your customers. With that, hopefully, if you sell more items, we can have higher profit margins, okay, with selling more items, okay, at a lower price. So we'll sell in volume. So one of the things with this, and I'll show you an example, I'm not going to show you here, but what happens is we're companies, okay, operate on certain points on this average cost scale. So real quick, this chart shows the relationship between costs and output. Output is going to be labeled Q, okay? Q is going to be output. So if I'm operating, okay, at that particular point, I have high costs and not a lot of output. So now if I continue to make more or offer more goods or services, I am hoping that my average costs will start to fall. So the more I make, or the more services I have out there, I am hoping that I am going to reach some area in here where I am operating at my lowest average cost. And this is in the notes with a PowerPoint on the Canvas page, at my greatest output. So if I can reach that area in here, this would be my optimal output level. Lowest cost, greatest output, hopefully very competitive in the market, lowered my prices because my costs are getting lower. And what this is called is trying to operate on economies of scale. We're trying to operate on economies of scale. Now, let me go to my notes real quick. How are we going to get there? Okay, there's two ways that we can do this. So we can operate on economies of scale, okay, by using our own resources. That is called internal economies of scale. So how are we going to lower our average costs and increase output? How are we going to do that? We're going to do that, okay, through what is called internal economies of scale, using our own resources. Now, here are some ways that you could do this. Number one, we can do managerial internal economies of scale, meaning this person, this manager, you, people enjoy working for you. People will work harder for you. People will work more efficient for you. So what happens is the manager, okay, is motivating employees to work a little bit harder without really paying them more money. Now, when we do managerial economies of scale, what you're going to do is you would have a manager for finance, you would have a manager for marketing, blah, 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 and blah, blah. So your managerial are based off four functions. Another way that you could reach internal economies of scale, okay, is through what is called technical. Better equipment. Updated technology. Automation. Robots. Drone. You're updating your technology, okay, to try and improve your output while lowering costs. Once again, we are trying to get to this area. We have to figure this out. And one way that you can do it is through internal economies of scale. Internal economies of scale, divide your management up. Okay, this group, the accounting kids or the marketing kids, you'll have a manager. We'll break it into specialized departments based off of the four functions. We can improve our technology. And then the other thing, as we grow, okay, we can start to, oh, let me see. Buying in bulk or purchasing economies of scale. So those are a couple quick things that we could use to achieve or try to achieve our economies of scale. Once again, internal economies of scale, we're using our own resources. So I know this is getting kind of long, so I'll stop it there. Just a quick pause, and then there'll be a video number two after this. But no song.